Candles work on a fairly simple and ingenious principle, the elements to sustain fire being contained in one convenient package. The fuel is the container made of wax. The catalyst that heats up the fuel is the wick. Once lit, the wax that is surrounding the flame melts and is drawn into and up the superabsorbent wick. The closer the wax gets to the flame, the hotter it becomes. By the time it reaches the flame, it is hot enough that the wax vaporizes, and it is the wax vapor that burns. The oxygen it needs is, of course, ever present in the air. There are several types of waxes used to make different types of candles. The most popular are paraffin, beeswax, tallow, babery, and soy. Because it is a byproduct of crude oil and can be manufactured cheaply to have several different melting temperatures, the most commonly used type of candle wax is paraffin. Low-melting paraffin has a melting point at or below 130 degrees Fahrenheit or 55.4 degrees Celsius. Medium-melting point paraffin melts at 130 to 145 degrees Fahrenheit or 54.4 to 62.7 degrees Celsius. And high-melting point paraffin melts at 145 to 150 degrees Fahrenheit or 62.7 to 65.5 degrees Celsius. The higher the melting point of paraffin, the harder and longer lasting the candle wax is. Noteworthy to the topic at hand is that almost all trick candles are paraffin wax candles. So that's all well and good, but why is it so hard to blow out a trick candle? When you blow out a normal candle, there is a small ember inside the wick itself that continues to burn for a time. This ember is hot enough to melt the wax, but not hot enough to ignite the vapor and continue the burning process. This ember eventually cools and the candle goes out completely. In trick candles, however, they add an ingredient that ignites at a lower temperature than the paraffin wax. This ingredient is usually a pyrophoric metal. Magnesium is the most commonly used pyrophoric metal in these trick candles, with the magnesium flakes embedded in the wicks. When you blow out the candle, the ember that remains is hot enough to light the magnesium, needing only to be around 800 degrees Fahrenheit or 426.6 degrees Celsius. Thus, when the magnesium burns, it burns so rapidly and at a high enough temperature that the paraffin wax vaporizes and ignites, and the burning process continues. Now, at this point, you might be wondering why all the magnesium in the wick doesn't light off when the trick candle is burning normally. The answer lies in how quickly the magnesium burns and how much oxygen is required to allow that process to occur. As the trick candle burns normally, the wick is cooled by the paraffin wax. The barrier that the wax creates between the magnesium in the wick and the air also helps to keep the magnesium from lighting. But once the candle is blown out, the wick is exposed to the ember and more air, and voila, the candle lights back up. And now for a bonus fact. A paraffin candle is easy to put out because only a tiny amount of wax is exposed to heat and therefore burns. Should an entire pool of liquid paraffin catch fire, it would be like any other hydrocarbon fire, like motor oil, and be extremely difficult to put out. The most common firefighting method to put out a hydrocarbon fire is to layer the burning pool with a blanket of foam, thereby separating the oxygen in the air from the burning liquid. And now for another bonus fact. The music to Happy Birthday to You was written down in 1893 by Patti and Mildred J. Hill. Originally with different lyrics entitled Good Morning to All, it was sung at the start of the school day. Despite that they likely copied the tune from somewhere else, and in turn someone else came up with the modern lyrics a couple of decades later, up until 2015 the song was copyrighted, earning a couple of $1 million annually for Warner Chappell Music, who claimed that they held the copyright. However, finally in 2015 a class action lawsuit against said company was settled for $14 million when Warner Chappell could no longer show that they actually held the copyright for the song, despite the fact that they'd been charging businesses to use the song the tune of about $2 million per year as mentioned. Thus, after well over a century, Happy Birthday is finally in the public domain. Interesting here is that before this, Happy Birthday's previous copyright status is why at certain restaurants they almost universally had their own unique version of the song that they sing to customers on their birthdays. Although there are reports of even older people, the oldest verified person ever was a French woman, Jean Calme, who died on the 4th of August 1997 at the age of 122 years, 164 days. This is possibly around the oldest any human could live to due to telomeres shortening. In a nutshell, telomeres prevent the strands of DNA from coming undone and also prevent them from accidentally fusing with neighboring chromosomes. The issue is that these end caps get shorter each time the cell divides, owing to the fact fact that the enzymes that duplicate the DNA, with a little help from short pieces of RNA, cannot do so all the way to the end of a chromosome, so something gets cut off every time a replication occurs. Telomeres ensure that what is cut off isn't critical information. But the result of this shortening each time is that telomeres eventually become too short to provide an adequate buffer. For reference, human cells can only be replicated around 40 to 70 times before the telomeres become too short. This leads to the cell no longer being able to correctly replicate and to cell death. So if you took every cell in your body at the time you were born and accounted for all the cells they would produce and so on, and multiplied that number by the average time it takes for those cells to die, you get what is known as the ultimate Hayflick limit, the maximum numbers of years that humans can theoretically live. That would be about 120 years, give or take. You can learn more about this in our video, Can Lobsters Really Not Die of Old Age? So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and don't forget to subscribe. Also, why not subscribe to another channel I do called Geographics? It's a geography-based channel. I'm going to link to that below. And as always, thank you for watching.